Gonna itch in my heart here. When you think about BPD, people with BPD discarding or ghosting you, or people with codependency not being able to stop being in contact when you don't go full no contact, here comes a question from somewhere in the middle of, you know, all the situations that people can be in with an ex or an on-off-again relationship, recycling, not sure. And for people that don't get into therapy and go full no contact, there's a lot of this sort of like limbo space out there. And so a commenter asked a question, is it possible that her texting me is her telling on herself anonymously? And if so, why? But it's really interesting because, you know, people ask all kinds of questions and that's fine. This is a good example of why people should not remain in contact after a relationship has ended, even when it's very painful, because most people who are in these relationships or were have codependency. And as I'm always saying, you need to get into therapy for healing and recovering from the codependency and the relationship breakup so you can really find out more about yourself, making yourself a much more healthy person, mentally healthy person who can be really independent and make much better choices in your life, and you will be more bounded. So to the question this person asks, you know, so if they're still with the person with BPD, or if you happen to be, or you're kind of an ex, but there's still this texting going on because you're not looking after yourself, is it possible that the person or a person with BPD is telling on themselves, himself or herself, anonymously when they're texting? Well, that's interesting in so many ways. Could they be telling on themselves anonymously? Well, you know, the fact is that people that are not that self-aware, and in the case of people with BPD untreated, they don't have a sense of self, they don't know themselves, they have a lost self, so they don't have any self-coherence or self-reference to be able to have other reference, which means they might well be leaking, if you will, you know, from an unconscious place, truth about themselves that they're otherwise not describing as such. But then that takes a lot of like delineating and parsing, and people could be guessing at things. Maybe some things would be more apparent than others. But you know what? If a person with BPD or untreated BPD specifically could be texting you and telling on themselves anonymously, in other words, leaking truth without being consciously aware of it, yes, that's possible, but I highly doubt it's like anything they're consciously aware of. It's not really going to help you out, because you're going to still have a lot of difficulty figuring out what's true and what's not true. Because not all people that are untreated with BPD, but a high percentage, like I said, don't have any self-awareness because of lack of self. So when they're lying, if they're lying, if they're manipulating, if they're just saying things you want to hear, then they could be telling on themselves anonymously, but in other words, unconsciously. But how are you really going to know that from what they tell you? Because, you know, that's really not an easy thing to really distinguish. And if you've been really hurt by somebody with BPD, or you're still being hurt by them because you're still in the relationship and you know what's going on and that they have BPD and they're untreated, etc., or you suspect highly they have BPD but they're not even diagnosed, then what could possibly change or get healthier or go well? And if you have to wonder when your partner, or if it's an ex-partner, if you have to wonder when they're texting you, if they're telling on themselves anonymously or unconsciously, then what are you even doing communicating with somebody that you can't, that you're not sure when they're telling you the truth, if they ever are, or if they're lying or being manipulative or just saying what you want to hear versus, quote, telling on themselves anonymously? And the other thing I would say about this is, people can tell on themselves anonymously if you're not self-aware. So people with codependency, people with other emotional challenges, people that don't know themselves well, people that are not as health, averagely mentally healthy as they could be, that don't have the kind of boundaries that they really need, People with codependency can tell anonymously or unconsciously on themselves as often and as much as people with BPD. And the only difference might be that people with codependency wouldn't have so much that would be so different from what you would say or be sharing as far as you know, right? Whereas people with BPD, there's many different levels and reasons why they're trying to obfuscate truth, and not necessarily always consciously, because they haven't faced their own reality. They haven't faced what's happening for them. They don't understand, or if they do know, that they don't really know who they are, and they lack self. They might not understand consciously how they impact you and how they impact others. And then, so when you respond because you've been hurt by what they said or did, and they don't know what's going on with that, which is no excuse for it, by the way, then the next thing you know is you're trying to talk to them. You're not going to get anywhere with an explanation because the person with untreated BPD themselves doesn't understand. And secondly, this idea of people, quote, telling on themselves, I'm going to say from the unconscious rather than anonymously, only being limited to people with BPD is not true. Can they be doing that? Like, can other people do that? The answer to both is yes. But the bottom line is, if you want to experience healthy love, not codependent love versus the fact that people with BPD untreated can't love you, don't attach to you, can't take in your love or your kindness or your caring, then what are you still doing there? Why are you still ensconced and trapped and blocked in and by your codependency? That, and I'm not saying this to the commenter, it's a general comment, but like the commenter, you might be asking or relate to the question, well, if I'm texting with the person with BPD in my life, untreated, or my ex, or whomever, are they going to be telling me things without realizing it that are true that goes against all that they're saying otherwise? Yeah, sure, that could happen with anybody. Like I said, not just somebody with BPD. It happens with people with codependency as well. But the bottom line is, just the very nature of the question is codependent. And the second thing about it is, it suggests a need for control. It suggests still wanting to try to change someone. And it also suggests that there's no trust there, which it wouldn't be, quote, abnormal, unquote, to not be trusting somebody when you highly suspect they have BPD, or when you know they've been diagnosed with it and they are untreated, because they don't know themselves, they don't know how they impact you, so they're not going to be trustworthy, and they're not going to trust you. So here is an overlap between BPD and codependency, in that people go ahead and think it's, quote, love, unquote, either way or whatever, without any trust and without inherent basic respect. Respect and trust are so important. I mean, they're integral, right? Integral part of any healthy relating, whether it's friendship, sibling, family, significant other. If you don't have trust for yourself to extend to other, and if you don't have respect for yourself and to require somebody else respect you and not disrespect you, if you don't have those fundamental boundaries and knowledge of self, not only are you highly codependent, maybe among other things for some people in some cases, but there's going to be no, absolutely zero healthy love when there is no respect and there is no trust. And so everything else asked around that or about that is increasingly codependent, because the questions are being asked from a place of codependency where people might not be consciously aware yet that they're trying to change reality, that they're working under the illusion of something wanted and desired that isn't going to happen or isn't there or that you can't trust. So if you want to try to parse whether or not somebody with BPD is texting you and telling on themselves unconsciously or anonymously, why would you even want to bother with that? Because that's a lack of self-respect, a lack of autonomy on your part, a need to control other And to know, quote, more than maybe they're sharing, and it's a lack of trust and a lack of self-respect and a lack of respect for them, and they can't respect you. So more to the point with this question, again, I would ask you, if you can relate to this question and to the comment with all due respect, this is rampant codependency again. This is codependence focusing on something else to do with the borderline or borderline X or whatever the case, instead of focusing on yourself. And what is a very difficult thing for people with codependency to do, because you may not have ever learned it in your life? Be proactive for you. It's not always about what are they doing? Are they doing this? Are they doing that? People with BPD or narcissists or whatever. More to the point, what are you doing? And why are you always worried about what are they doing so you can know what's going on or what they're doing? The inherent repetition compulsion externalizing out of control needs and codependency. Make no mistake about it. You need, if you've been in a relationship with someone with BPD or NPD and or have a family member, whatever relationship type, you need therapy. I'm out here to work with you if I resonate with you. You need therapy to work through all of this family of origin issues, the wounded inner child, so many other aspects of this, and to heal from your codependency, to know yourself better, to get the closure that you really need for a lot of things in your life, and not just a BPD X, but that too. You need to know yourself better, and you need to get into this healing and therapy work to be able to move forward and to learn self-respect and boundaries and know more about yourself and create a healthy relationship to and with yourself. The challenge for codependents on the other side of someone with BPD or not trusting someone else in your life or whatever the case, like this question could be asked from. The bottom line is, if you're in some chaotic, dramatic struggle for what is truth, what are they saying now, do they really mean what they're saying, are they lying to me? This is the codependent illusion to delusion of the idea that there's anything there worth fighting for. And it is your codependency, what you're unaware about it still, which just my saying it here isn't going to change your life. You have to get into therapy and understand it in your emotional landscape and to work through this process that's required for recovery from BPD and these, I'm sorry, codependency and these relationships. Bottom line is, you probably, if you have codependency, relate to this commenter's question, relate to this. You don't know yourself well enough. Your codependency is stronger than you think. And if you don't heal it and get into therapy, nothing's going to change for you. Meanwhile, you're not focused on yourself at all. You're externalizing everything out onto the person with BPD or the ex or whomever they are in your life. And like I said, there's nothing healthy about that. This isn't going to help you. It's not going to help them. It's not going to salvage your relationship. It's not going to make an impossible, unworkable, unhealthy bond between a codependent and a borderline work. So why aren't you focusing on you yet? And by the way, stay tuned. I have a codependency recovery podcast coming. Many more resources. I'm available to work with in one-on-one sessions if you resonate with me. And I will also have courses coming. So just know codependency is unhealthy. And the more you focus on that person with BPD and are they like texting me and when they text me, why are you texting with them still, right? But if they're texting you, are they telling on themselves anonymously? Do you realize how far gone you are from yourself and how much you're abandoning yourself? If you even have to ask that question, and I mean that with all due respect to the person that asked the question and anybody that resonates with it.